the different instructions available? What are the sets, different types of instructions that are available in 8086 that we are going to discuss in today's class? First one, we will see what is meant by instruction. Okay, this is about instruction. So instruction means it is a binary pattern designed inside a microprocessor to perform the specific function. We know that what is meant by instruction means whenever you have been given any task, so you have to write a program. So what is meant by program means it is a set of instruction. So what is instruction again means it is a binary pattern designed inside a microprocessor to perform specific function. In general, actually, that the processor understand only the machine language, it won't understand the high level language. But what we do is we are writing program only in high level language. So high level language means English language. Okay, so every language have some syntaxes. For example, if I am writing a program in C language, I have to include the header file, then followed by main function. That and all we have to write. But the system does not understand anything. So what it will do is it will convert the program, that is high level language, into machine level language. So only the machine level language is understand by the system. So here, what is meant by instruction means it is a binary pattern designed inside a microprocessor to perform a specific function. As I told, in every instruction you have two parts. One is the opcode. So what is meant by opcode means it is a short form of operational code. It stands for operational code. So what it will do is it specifies the type of operation to be performed by the CPU. Okay, so what type of operation we are going to perform, whether we are going to perform the data transfer operation or whether we are going to perform the arithmetic and logical operation. So like that, we have a lot of operations are available. So what that opcode will specify is it specifies the type of operation. So what type of operation we are going to perform on the performed by the CPU, that is called as opcode. Okay, it is a first field in the machine language instruction format. Normally in our instruction format, first one is an opcode followed by an operand. So here, so we have move x comma y. Okay, so move means it is a data transfer instruction. So x and y, so assume that x and y are here operand. Okay, so what is meant by operand means we can say that it is a data on which the operation should act. Okay, whatever data we are giving, on that data the operation we are going to perform. Suppose move x comma y means whatever content that is available in y, that will be moved into x. Similarly, suppose add al comma bl. So previous class we saw the different registers, so I can write like this: add ax comma bx. So now what it will do is here add is an opcode followed by two operands, ax and bx. So these two are the operands. So what it will do is it will add the content of ax and bx, and it will store the result back to ax. Okay, this is called as instruction. Okay, in general, as I told, instruction contains two things. One is an opcode. This one is an opcode, and this is a operand. So opcode followed by operand. So normally in 8086 we have two operands. One is a source operand, and the second one is a destination operand. General here, second one. So this one is a source operand, and this one is a destination operand. So what is the meaning of this instruction is, this instruction will perform the addition of ax plus bx, and store the result back to ax. So ax plus bx, and it will store the result back to ax. So this is operand. And assembler. So what is meant by assembler means it converts the instruction into sequence of binary bits. As I told, what we are writing, it is called as an assembly language program. In microprocessor, normally in 8086, whatever program we are writing, that program is called as assembly language program. So the assembly language program, the processor does not understand the assembly language program. So what we need is, we need a converter or translator to translate the assembly language program into machine level language. So what is machine level language means? It consisting of binary bits, that is zeros and ones. It contains only zeros and ones. That is called as assembler. So assembler means, what is assembler means? It converts the assembly language program into machine language program. Okay. For that we are using the assembler. One more translator we have, that is called as compiler. So compiler, what the compiler will do is, compiler will convert the high level language into machine level language, any high level language, whatever language we are using. So for example, C language, Java, Python, everything, what we are writing is a high level language. So that high level language, the processor does not understand the high level language. So what we need is, we need to convert the high level language into a machine level language. For that purpose we are using the compiler, but here we need assembler, because the program we are writing in 8086 in assembly language, assembly language only. So that assembly language program will be converted into machine level language program with the help of assembler. Okay, so this one, mnemonics. So so what we are writing, that opcode, we make other name for opcode is an mnemonics. These are symbolic codes for either instructions or commands to perform a particular function. These are some examples. So move, add, sub. Move means it is a data transfer instruction, add then sub. Okay, so these are all the mnemonics. These are the instruction set basics. Okay, so far any doubts, my students? So far anybody having any doubts? Say yes or no. Any doubts? Okay, so I'll move to the next slide. Okay, so we will see one by one what are the different types of instructions available with examples. Okay, first one is a data transfer instruction. Okay, so when we need a data transfer instruction, so data transfer instruction means your program may be available in memory. So what we need to do is, we need to transfer it from memory into processor. So memory into processor. So for that purpose we need a data transfer instruction. So this is a mnemonics for data transfer in the instructions. Okay, first one, that is a MOV, move. Okay, so the meaning is move. So the syntax format is like this: MOV move D comma S. So what is D denotes for is, D denotes for destination and S denotes for source. Okay, for example, if I am writing like this, move AL comma BL. So move AL comma BL, what it will do is, whatever the content available in BL, that will be moved into AL. Suppose in my BL I have a data 05H, so it is a hexadecimal format. So 05, data is 05, so this content will be moved into AL. So 05 is moved into AL. This is a data transfer, first data transfer instruction. Then we have exchange. Okay, so exchange means XCHG. This is called as exchange. So again, exchanging means the content available in source will be transferred into destination, and the content available in destination will be transferred into source. So we know that exchange, exchanging means interchanging. Okay, then we have LEA. So what is LEA means? It is a loading the effective address. So as I told in the last class, so apart from the immediate addressing mode and register addressing mode, we calculate effective address for every instruction. Okay, so last class, that is previous class, we saw how to calculate an effective address for each and every instruction. That is how to calculate for direct, in the indexed, based, then based indexed, then based indexed displacement, string addressing mode. So for every addressing mode, we saw how to calculate an effective address. So that is called as LEA. LEA means loading the effective address. The next operation is push, push and pop. So push and up, push and pop operation you already know. Okay, so what is meant by push and pop means, push the operand into the top of the instruction. Okay, that is called as pushing. So here I have given an example. So what is the example I have given is, push BX. So BX means base register. So whatever content available in BX, So that will be moved into the top of the stack. That is, pushes the operand into top of the stack. That is called as push operation. Similarly, pop. So pop means it pops the operand from the top of the stack. So again, pop BX. So whatever content available in the top of the stack, so that will be popped. That is called as pop operation. Then we have in and out. So what is in and out means? In means it transfers the operand from specified port to the accumulator register. Okay, transfers the operand from the specified port to the accumulator register. So here one format is given. Example, in followed by AX comma 0028. So what it will do is it transfers the operand from the specified port. So this here we are mentioning the port number. So port number is 28. So whatever operand available in this particular port number, that will be moved into accumulator register. That is called as in operation. Similarly, out. So what is meant by out means it transfers the operand from accumulator into specified port. Okay, so it is a reverse of in instruction. So in means it transfers the operand from the specified port into accumulator. Here port number is 28. So whatever operand available in this port number, that will be moved into accumulator. Similarly, out. So out means, so it transfers the operand from accumulator into specified port. These are the different data transfer instruction. And next one is arithmetic instructions. Okay, so far anybody is having doubts? So far, anybody is having doubts? If anybody is having doubts in between, you can ask in chat box also. Okay, so you are responding, somebody's mic is not working. In that cases, you can respond in the chat box. Okay. Wait, you connect to some other network. I'm not able to hear your voices. Okay, ma'am. Am I audible, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. So next we will see the arithmetic instructions. So these are the different arithmetic instructions. Okay. Subtract with borrow. We will see one by one. First one is subtract. So the mnemonic name is SUB, meaning subtract. This is a format sub of D comma S. So what is S here is it is a source, and what is meant by D means it is a destination. So what it will do is we subtract D minus S, and we store the result back into destination. So this is how we can calculate the subtract operation. Subtract sub D comma S. So D minus S. So D means destination and S means source. So D minus S, that is destination, whatever content available in destination, minus whatever content available in source, then the result again stored in destination. So if there is any borrow means that will be stored in the carry flag. We already saw about the carry flag. What is meant by carry flag? So when the carry flag will be set is whenever you are getting any carry from addition operation or subtraction operation, then that value will be moved into carry flag, CF. So CF denotes for carry flag. Then next instruction is a SBB. So what is meant by SBB means it is a subtract with the borrow. What is meant by SBB denotes for is SBB denotes for subtract with borrow. So again, name of the instruction is format is SBB subtract with the borrow followed by DS. So what it will do is D minus S minus carry flag. Subtract with the borrow. Okay, then the result will be stored in destination. So previously subtract instruction, subtract destination, subtract the source from the destination. But as far as subtract with borrow is concerned, it subtract source and the carry flag from the destination. That is called as subtract with the borrow instruction. Then decrement, DEC. So DEC means it is a decrement instruction. So we know that in lot of languages have auto increment and auto decrement. So this one decrement, DEC means it is a decrement. So it will decrement by one. So for example here, decrement D. So D means it is a destination. So destination minus one. Suppose my destination value is 0, 5. So what it'll do is 5 minus 1. So what is 5 minus 1 is 4. So that 4 will be stored in the destination. That is called as decrement memory. So DEC. So DEC denotes for decrement. Similarly, increment. So increment here we are using INC. So INC means increment the destination value by 1. Suppose my destination value, content of the destination is 5 means, then 1 will be added with the destination. So my new content will be 6. That is your increment operator. So negate. So negate means negating the destination. Then these are all add with the carry. So add means it is an addition. So addition. So what it will do is, we already told this example, add D comma S. So content of source and the content of destination will be added, and the result is stored in destination. That is called as add. Then add with the carry. So for add with the carry, what is the instruction name? Is it is ADC. ADC means it is a add with carry. So then again, destination comma source. So what it will do is, it will add the carry flag also. So your result will be S plus D plus CF, source plus destination plus carry flag, and the result is again stored in destination. This is called as add with carry. Okay, so then we have AAA, ASCII adjustment for addition. Then DAA means a decimal adjustment addition. Then AAS, ASCII adjust for subtraction. DAS means a decimal adjust for subtraction. So these are all the different instruction we are using related to ALU. It is arithmetic and logical unit. Okay. Any doubts so far this arithmetic instruction? Anybody is having doubts, ma? If anybody is having doubts, you can ask. Okay, I hope you have no doubts. So I repeat the arithmetic instruction again. This is addition. Okay, so this is actually an addition. This is addition with carry. These two are addition operation. Similarly, these two are subtraction. Subtract with borrow. These two are the subtraction operation. Then increment and decrement. These are all decrement and this is increment. Then we have ASCII adjustment for addition, ASCII decimal adjustment for addition. This one AAS means ASCII adjust for subtraction, and AAA means ASCII adjustment for addition. Then DAS. So DAS means decimal adjustment for subtraction, DAA means decimal adjustment for addition. Okay, so far any doubts? So far any doubts, ma? So I will tell one example for this. Only format is given. If possible, I will explain on this. Suppose I am writing add. How to write for add is add AL comma BL. This is addition operation. Okay, so what will happen is AL, assume that my AL value is equal to 0, 5. My BL value, assume that my BL value is 0, 4. How it will do the addition and subtraction is 0, 5. What is the binary for 0, 5, ma?
Said 9.
Binary, ma. Binary for 0, 5. Binary value for 0, 5.
0, 1, 0, 1.
0, 1. 0 1 0 1 0. Okay. Then for BL 0 0 4. What is the binary value for 0 4?
1 0 0, sir.
0 1 0 0. Now what it will do is it will do the addition. So addition means what it will do is 0 1 1 0 is 1 actually here. 1 0 is 1. Again 0 0 is 0. Again 1 1. We have 0. Carry is 1. Again 1. So now what will be the value is 1 0 0 1. This is addition operation. Now where your result will be stored is result will be stored in destination. So AL. So what is now AL, new AL values? So AL equal to 1 0 0 1. This is called as addition operation. So like this we will write for all the other arithmetic instructions. Okay, next one. These are all the bit manipulation instructions. Okay, bit manipulation you already know. Okay, so that is logical AND, logical OR, then logical NOT. Okay, so logical AND operation you already know. Okay, I will give some examples. So AND operation. So what is meant by AND operation means whenever you are doing AND operation, if both are ones means your result will be 1. If any one bit is having value 0 means then the entire result will be 0. Okay. For example, I will write one example. For logical AND, I will give one example. So assume that AND. Okay. So what is the instruction name is, we can write it as AND, AND. So AND of D comma S. Okay, AND of D comma S. So assume that I am writing AND of AL comma BL. So what it will do is assume that my AL value is 0 1 0 1 and my BL value is 1 0 1 0. Can anybody tell what will be stored in AL? What will be the answer? What is 0 1? AND of 0 1.
AND, sir.
AND.
0, sir.
That means 0. 1 0.
1 0.
1 0 is 0. Again 0 1 0. Again 1 0 is 0. So what it will be stored in AL is 0 0 0 0. Similarly, we can write for OR operation. So OR, how we can write is OR of AL comma BL. So I'll take the same example. So AL. So assume that it is 0 1 0 1 and BL. So it is 1 0 1 0. Now we are performing OR. So can you tell what is R of 0 1?
Sir, all 1 only, 4 1.
All 1. So 0 1 is 1, 1 0 is 1, again 0 1 is 1 and 1 0 is 1. So what is the content of AL is? So content of AL is 1 1 1 1. So like this it will be stored. Okay, so these are all some logical operations. So logical AND, logical OR, XOR. Okay. So what will happen in XOR is, what is XOR of 1 1? XOR
0, sir.
1 1 is 0 and 0 0 is also 0. 0 1 means 1 and 1 0 means it is 1. That is the XOR operation. So this is how it will perform the AND operation, OR operation. XOR and NOT. NOT means negation. So 1 means 0, 0 means 1. That is called as logical NOT operation. So this is the bit manipulation instructions. The next one is shift and rotate. Okay, so next operation is shift and rotate instruction. Shift and rotate instruction, we got, these are the shift and rotate instruction. First one, SAL or SHL, shift arithmetic left or shift logical left. Then SHR means shift logical right. SAR means shift arithmetic right. Okay, these are the syntaxes for everything. SAL, shift arithmetic left. SHL, shift logical left. SHR, shift logical right. SAR, shift arithmetic right. Okay. Similarly, rotate instruction. These are the rotate instruction. This is a ROL, rotate left. This is rotate right. This is rotate left through carry and rotate right through carry. Okay. Name of the instruction is ROL. Okay. This is how the format is ROL D comma count. For example, if I am writing example as ROL AL comma 1. Assume that I am writing like this ROL AL, rotate left AL comma 01. So assume that my AL value is 5. So what is the binary for 5 is 0101. Okay, when we rotate left by 1, what you will get result? What you will get, ma? Rotate left by 1. So my AL value is 05 means it is, what is the binary value of 5 is 0101. When we rotate left by 1 bit, can you tell what is the answer? Rotate it left side, ma. Left side means that 0 will gone. So what will happen is 101. So here empty space, so put it as 0. So when we rotate left by 1 bit, so this is the answer you will get, 1010. Okay. Similarly, rotate right. Here you can give the count. Okay, here you can give the, yes. So how many number of bits you want to rotate, that count you can give it here. ROL D comma count. So 2, 3, 1. So whatever count you are giving, that number of times the bit will be rotated. That is ROL, rotate left. Similarly, rotate right. Then rotate left through carry. So this one, it will be rotated along with carry. And again, rotate right through carry. This one rotated right along with carry. This is the shift and rotate instructions. The next instruction is a branching. Can anybody tell what is meant by branching instructions? Anybody?
Sir, instructions which change the flow of control in a particular code.
What, ma? Instructions?
A set of code or instructions which will change the flow of control in any code.
Yes.
For example, else file.
Tell me. Yes.
For instance, we have if else, then we have the different loops. So they will change the flow of control momentarily.
Yes. So we have two types of instructions. Okay, so one instruction is called as sequential and other instruction is called as branching. So sequential instruction means your instructions are executed one by one. Okay, so it won't affect the flow of control. So whatever order the programs are there, so in that program order your program will be executed. But as far as sequential branching instruction is concerned, it will affect the flow of execution. That is, based on results, it will go somewhere. That is called as branching instruction. We have two types of branching. One is a conditional branching and other one is a unconditional branching. Okay. So this is, in general, the branching instructions. What are the different branching instruction we have is call. This is one instruction. Call means call a subroutine. Okay, then RET. So what is meant by RET means it returns the control from the procedure to calling program. It returns the control from procedure to the calling program. That is returning. So whenever we are calling calling the function or subroutine, it will go there. When we return, it will come to the calling program. That is called as return instruction RET. Then jump, JMP. So what is meant by jump? So we have two type of jump is there. One is unconditional jump and other one is conditional jump. So what is meant by unconditional jump means we will not check any condition. Simply it will go to the destination. Whatever label you are giving, in that label it will go. But in case of conditional jump, it will check the condition before jump. Based on the condition, it will make the decision. Okay. This is about branching instructions. The next one is a string instructions. Okay. String instruction actually, these are the different string instructions. First one is CMPS. So mnemonics. What is a mnemonic is CMPS. So CMPS is a mnemonic. Compares the string bytes, destination and source. It compares the string bytes, so it will compare here. Source and destination, string byte, it will compare. That is called as string instruction. Okay. Then we have SCAS, followed by string. What it will do is, it will scan the string. So SCAS means it scans a string. Then next instruction is this one, move S, move SB, move SW. So moving of byte or word. Okay, then REP. So REP means repetition of instruction. So what is meant by REP means? So REP means repeat. That is a repetition of the instruction. String instruction means these are the four string instruction we got. CMPS, compare string bytes. SCAS, scan string. Third one is move. Move S. Move S. This is move string. Move string byte. Move string word. Moving a byte or word. Then REP. So REP means repetition of the instruction. That is called as REP. That is repetition of the instruction. Okay, ma. So far, anybody is having doubts?
No, sir.
What about others?
So branching instructions, again you say, sir.
Branching, yes. These are the branchings. So branching means actually, there are two types of instruction for every programs. We have two type of instruction. One is sequential and another one is branching. So sequential means it will be executed one by one. First instruction, program instruction 1, instruction 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that it will execute. But in case of branching, so it will go, whenever some condition is satisfied, it will go to somewhere. So no flow of control, flow sequentially it will not execute. That kind of instruction is called as branching. Suppose for example, I got some function call here. I have 1, 2, 3, I am executing here. Assume that you have a function call. If you have a function call, then the fourth instruction will not execute. It will directly come to the function call. It will execute it. So once return, once we are returning RET, by using RET instruction, we are returning. So once we return, it will come here, then fourth instruction. So third instruction completed. Then after completing the third, it will go to fourth. So if it is sequential, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Now it is 1, 2, 3. Assume that this is a 10th instruction. So 10, 11, 12 will be executed. Once we return again, it will come here. Then after that, it will execute the fourth instruction. So that kind of instruction is called as branching instruction. So call, this is actually a function call. It calls a subroutine. Return, again returns the control from the procedure to the calling program. Jump, JMP means it is a jump, unconditional jump, this conditional jump. String instruction. Then these are all some processor control instruction. So processor control means we already saw about different conditional flags. Okay, so that conditional flags we can set and clear. Suppose here STC. STC means setting the carry flag. So carry flag means CF. So this is a carry flag. Suppose if you want to set the carry flag, you can use simply STC. So STC means what it will do is it will set the carry flag into one. Similarly, CLC. So CLC means clearing the carry flag. If you use CLC instruction, so your flag, that is carry flag, will be cleared into zero. Now what is your CF values? CF values zero. Then STD. STD means direction flag. So what is meant by direction flag means whether we are moving from lower address to higher address or higher address into lower address. So that is called as direction flag. So suppose if you want to set the direction flag, so you can use the STD STD instruction. STD means setting the direction flag. Suppose if you want to clear the direction flag, you got to use the CLD flag. So CLD means clearing the direction flag. So suppose if you want to halt, if you want to stop the program execution, you can go for HLT. HLT means halt, stop fetching and execution. That is called as halt. HLT denotes for halt. And next one is NOP. So NOP means no operation. Suppose if you are in between, if you want to stop execution or processing, we can go for no op instruction. So no operation means no operation will be performed, no processing. Then lock. So lock means control of system bus is not taken by other microprocessor. Okay, system bus. Whenever the microprocessor is performing operation, it will take the control of the system bus. Once we are locking the system bus, it won't be taken by the other microprocessor. That is called as lock. Then wait. So wait means CPU will not do any processing. It will wait for something to complete. Some process will complete. Then escape.